Oh, I suppose a fellow should stick to his own trade, but I know some pretty big men around here that might not be averse to a deal like this if they're properly approached. Highly respectable men, I might add. So why don't you let me see what I can do before you look for a fence? A few days more or less wouldn't make much difference to you, I don't suppose. Might mean a lot more money for all of us.
Good. There's just one thing. I dislike to mention it, but I've just come from prison and...
Oh, well, of course, Cobby here will be glad to advance you anything you need. See that you have a place to stay. Hey, Cobby?
Well, you bet your life. And I got some fancy phone numbers for you, too, Doc.
What's it like, a man of your taste, 7 years behind the walls?
Not too bad. It's a matter of temperament. I cause no trouble. The prison authorities appreciate that. They made me assistant librarian.
I'm afraid I wouldn't make a model prisoner.
After this job, it's Mexico for me. I live like a king. Mexican girls are very pretty. I'll have nothing to do all day long but chase them in the sunshine. You've been very kind, sir.
Good night. Good
night. Stavrig?
Copy.
What's the big idea standing there staring at me, Uncle Lon?
Don't call me Uncle Lon.
I thought you liked it.
Maybe I did. I don't anymore.
I had the market send over some salt mackerel for you. I know how you love it for breakfast.
Some sweet kid. It's late. Why don't you go to bed? Some sweet kid.